Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pateye Namaha. Ayodhya Kand, chapter number 117, Maharishi Atri. After the sages left Chitrakuta, Rama decided to leave Chitrakuta as well. And he reaches the hermitage of sage Atri Muni and offers him his salutation. Mother Sita receives wonderful instruction from Atri Muni's wife, Mother Anasuya, on the duties and responsibilities of a devoted wife. Verse 1. Raghava tu apayateshu tapas vishu vichintayan natatra arochayad vasam karaner bahube tada. After the ascetics had departed, Rama took calm counsel within himself and saw many a reason why he should not stay there. Verse 2. Iha me bharato drishto matarahcha sanagara sacha me smritir anveti tan nityam anashochataha. My heart will be pained at the memory of the visit paid me here by Bharata, the royal ladies and the citizens. Verse 3. Skanda avara niveshena tena tasya mahatmanaha haya hasti karishae cha upamardha krito brisham. Again, this place has been rendered foul and unclean by the stay of the huge army of Bharata. Countless horses, elephants, camels, bulls and cows camped here, and these woods are very much the worse for it. Verse 4. Tasmad anyatra gachama iti sanchintya raghava pratishthata sa vaidehya lakshmanena cha sangataha. We shall therefore go to some other place. Having resolved thus, Rama, accompanied by Sita and Lakshmana, set forth. Verse 5. So atrir ashramam asadya tam vavande mahayasha tam chapi bhagavan atri putravat pratyapadyata. On the way, after reaching the hermitage of sage Atri, the highly celebrated Rama reverently laid his head at the feet of the sage. The saint looked upon them as his own children and extended to them the heartiest welcome. Verse 6. Svayam atithyam adishya sarvam asya susatkritam saumitrim cha mahabhagam sitam cha samasantvayat. That sage Atri himself extended to Rama the hospitality befitting him in all possible ways and treated Lakshmana and the highly virtuous Sita with kind words. So why is Sita called as highly virtuous or Mahabhagam? Because she is very fortunate that she is following Rama. And in this chapter, she is the recipient of the dharma of women as spoken by Mother Anasuya herself, who is an extremely chaste wife. And therefore, Valmiki is saying that Mother Sita is Mahabhagam, because for one chaste wife to learn the duties of a wife from another chaste wife is a matter of extreme honor and extreme good fortune. Verse 7. Patnim chatam anupraptam vridham amantriya satkritam santavyam asadharmagnya sarva bhuta hiterata. Conversant in the ways of righteousness and engaged in the welfare of all beings, sage Atri called out to his aged wife, who is revered by all, and spoke kind words to her. So we see multiple things over here. So first of all, Atri Muni is dharmagnya, the one who is conversant with dharma, who knows righteousness. The second one is Sarvabhuta Hite, the one who wants the welfare of all living entities. So he is a true devotee because the Lord is Suhridam Sarvabhutanam. Now a devotee of the Lord also sees everyone as the children of the Lord, as the servants of the Lord. Therefore, there is no one whom he hates or despises, and he is the best well-wisher for every single living entity. So that's why he is Sarvabhute Hite Rata. Mother Anasuya is referred to as aged or Vriddham, and she is also referred to as Satkritam, the one who is revered by all. The aged portion is just to show that she is in the Vatsalya Rasa, where she can take a look at the Universal Mother, Mother Sita, as if she were her own daughter. Therefore, Valmiki has given that information of Vriddham, that she is aged. And she is revered by all. What is the reason for which she is revered? We will see that she is revered because of her chastity. This is the power of a woman. And how does Sage Atri speak to Mother Anasuya? Using very kind and gentle words. Santavyamasa. Very kind words. That is how a husband is supposed to treat his wife. So in this one verse, we learn so much about the relationship between Mother Anasuya and Sage Atri. Verse 8. Anasuya Mahabhagam Tapasim Dharmacharinim Prati Grihnishva Vaidehim Abravit Rishi Sattama Ramaya Cha Achak Chakshe Tam Tapasim Dharmacharinim. The excellent sage Atrimuni said to his highly virtuous and ideal ascetic wife, Mother Anasuya, I commend our girl Janaki to your care. Welcome her. Thereafter, he related to Rama a story about his ascetic wife who follows the ways of righteousness. Once again, let us dissect this verse. So, Anasuya is referred to as Mahabhaga, the one who is highly virtuous, the highly fortunate one, because she gets the association of Mother Sita. Few verses ago, Mother Sita was referred to as Mahabhaga, but here Valmiki calls Mother Anasuya as Mahabhaga. And she is also known as Tapasin, you know, the female ascetic. And she is called as Dharmacharinim, the one who follows Dharma. How is Atrimuni referred to over here? Valmiki calls him as Rishi Sattama, the excellent among the sages, the best of sages, because he has such a wonderful wife as Mother Anasuya. And knowing that Rama loves righteousness, Rama is the embodiment of Dharma, Atrimuni tells Rama how Mother Anasuya is a Dharmacharini. How Mother Anasuya is a proper tapasin. That's why in this verse, tapasim and dharmacharinim are referred twice for the same person, Mother Anasuya. Why? Because she is going to instruct Mother Sita and this entire world on the duties of a good wife. Therefore, Valmiki specifies over and over again that she is a proper adherent of Dharma, that she follows Dharma, and Rama himself listened to her glories. Therefore, anything that Mother Anasuya says has to be taken with reverence, and it should be put into proper practice. Now we will see how a chaste wife is truly powerful. Verses 9, 10, 11, and 12. Dashavarshani anavrishtaya dagde loke nirantaram yaya moola phale shrishte jahnavi cha pravartita ugrena tapasa yukta niyamai chapi alankrita dashavarsha sahasrani yaya tap Mahattapa Anasuya Vratayata Prityuha Cha Nibarhita Devakarya Nimittam Cha Yaya Santva Ramanaya Dasharatram Kritva Ratri Sa Iyam Mata Ivate Anagha. Anasuya is ever intent upon practicing the highest dharma. Her yogic might is something inconceivable. Once in the far past, there was a terrible drought for 11 years. Plant and herb, flower and leaf, creeper and tree faded and withered. Yet she created them out of her tapas and caused a full current of water to flow in the Ganga. On another occasion, to serve the purpose of the gods, she converted 11 days into one night. Thousands of years have passed over her head while she sat in stern tapas, keeping the vows and observances. Dangers and perils, obstacles and trials have shattered themselves against her iron will. Reverence her as the mother that bore you. Verse 13. Tam imam sarvabhutanam namakaryam yashasvinim abhigacchatu vaidehi vriddham akrodhanam sada. She deserves the worship and adoration of all beings. Her fame is equaled but by her years. Anger and wrath are not to be spoken of in the same breath with her. For the good of the world, she has practiced stern tapas impossible for any other. She has no peer in watchful service and loyal devotion to her husband. Hence, her greatness is the despair of envy. Rightly has she been named Anasuya above envy. Sita remains with her. Verse 14. Evam bruvanam tam rishim tatha iti uktvasa raghava sitam uvacha dharmagnyam idam vachanam uttamam. Hearing the words of the sage, Rama said, "So be it," and then spoke to Sita, the righteous one, these choice words. Verse 15. Rajaputri Shrutam tu etan muner asya samiritam shreyo artham atmana shigram abhigaccha tapasvinim. O Sita, the daughter of King Janaka, the Lord of Wisdom, mark too what the Maharishi advised us to secure unparalleled good to us. Hasten to the side of the noble lady Anasuya without any delay. So Rama calls Sita here as a Rajaputri. Rajaputri means the daughter of a king or a princess. But why is he addressing Sita as Rajaputri? Number one, it is the duty of kings and the people of the Kshatriya class to listen to what the Brahmins have to say. To reverence the Brahmins, to protect the Brahmins, and to learn from the Brahmins so that the rest of the world is uplifted. So it is Sita's duty to listen to the instructions as spoken by Mother Anasuya so that the whole world can benefit from Mother Anasuya's knowledge of how to be a chaste wife. Now, there is a second reason behind this. Who is Mother Sita's father, King Janaka? King Janaka is a Raja Rishi, the ascetic king, the royal sage. And therefore, as his daughter, Mother Sita is naturally inclined towards receiving instruction from the elders. And now the third reason. Despite being a Rajaputri, despite being a princess, Rama knows that there will come a time in the future when Sita will have to prove her chastity to the world. Obviously, Sita happily overcame the multiple temptations given to her for one whole year by Ravana and his band of Rakshasas. And for once and for all, she proved to the world that she is a very chaste wife. And therefore, Rama calls her Rajaputri. And he says, Shrutam, you have heard these words as spoken by the sage. Now please sit down very close to Anasuya and listen from her for what? For Shreya Artham, for your own good. Shreya Artham Atmanaha, for your good. Listen to the words as spoken by Anasuya. So, Rama is also teaching the rest of the world, to all the women out there, if you want to know what is for your own good, listen to the words as spoken by Mother Anasuya and as listened to by Mother Sita herself. Verse 16. Sita tu etat vacha shrutva ragavasya hita eshini tam atripatnim dharmagnyam abhi chakram maithili. Loyal to the least wish of Rama, who ever sought her welfare and happiness, Sita, the daughter of Mithila, circumambulated the virtuous Anasuya, Atrimuni's wife. We will learn more about the interactions between Mother Sita and Mother Anasuya in the next section.